Imagining the unpaired electron in an empty 2p atomic orbital allows us to add this unique frontier orbital to our repertoire of reactive frontier molecular orbitals. Like the empty atomic, or A orbital, the half-filled H orbital has both the appearance and energy of a 2p atomic orbital. However, it is unique in that it contains only one electron. Thus, it doesn't fit neatly into our characterization of frontier molecular orbitals as occupied or unoccupied. The H orbital is in a league of its own. Like a filled orbital, H cannot interact with any of the other filled atomic orbitals. Such an interaction would place one electron in the resulting intermediate in a highly destabilized antibonding orbital. Thus, H frontier orbitals in radicals can only interact with sigma star, pi star, or other H frontier molecular orbitals. Notice in the example shown here that when a radical reacts with these orbitals, one electron from the sigma or pi bond forms a new bond with the radical. The second electron of the sigma or pi bond becomes a new unpaired electron in the resulting intermediates. We can extend this idea to pi-type interactions in resonance stabilized radicals. Unpaired electrons next to double bonds or triple bonds are delocalized. If I simply add a double bond onto the end of the radical drawn here, the resulting structure is the allyl radical. Because the radical is next to a double bond, we can see that an H to pi star pi-type interaction is possible in the allyl radical. The curved arrows for this interaction look like this, and the resulting resonance structure looks like this. Similar resonance structures are possible for the propargylic radical, which is adjacent to a triple bond. Again, in this case, the important resonance interaction is a pi-type interaction between a half-filled H orbital and an empty pi star. As you might expect, these resonance-stabilized radicals are more stable than the corresponding radicals without resonance. In fact, we can make a direct analogy to the allyl cation, which is more stable than its counterpart lacking resonance. The true molecular orbitals in the allyl cation and radical are in fact identical. The only difference is the addition of a single electron to the MOs of the radical. What this means is that you can use a tool like SCHMO to calculate the orbitals of a resonance-stabilized radical. Simply treat the radical center as an sp2 hybridized atom, and remember that radicals are neutral, and that you'll end up with an unpaired electron in your set of molecular orbitals. As with the other frontier molecular orbitals, you can use the H orbital as a tool to help you remember how radicals react. In the next webcast, we'll explore the stability trends of radicals and how they are generated in radical reactions.